Hey guys, welcome back to Tenorshare AI's channel. Apple recently announced the release of model family of the OpenELM on Hugging Face. This video will take you on a quick tour of Apple's AI model OpenELM. OpenELM is claimed to be a state-of-the-art open language model. Its models contain 270 million, 450 million, 1.1 billion and 3 billion parameters sizes, which is much smaller than the Microsoft's Phi-3 Mini. Apple released a complete framework this time, including training logs, multiple checkpoints, and pre-training configurations. I have to say it's quite useful to the open research community. The first thing we will explore is the model architecture. OpenELM adopts the transformer model architecture, which is particularly suitable for dealing with long-distance dependent linguistic phenomena, such as understanding complex sentence structures and contextual relationships in long texts. Based on the optimized transformer model architecture, OpenELM adopts a layer-wise scaling strategy. To understand it simply, imagine a multi-layered library with different categories of books on each layer, and in order to make the library operate more efficiently, you decide to flexibly assign librarians according to the number of books stored on each layer. Adopting such a strategy results in a 2.36% increase in accuracy for OpenELM compared to ALMO at about 1 billion parameter size, while requiring 2x fewer pre-training tokens. Now, let's take a look at pre-training and training data. OpenELM is trained with 1.8 trillion tokens, and its training data comes from public datasets such as Reddit. Wikipedia exhibits an accuracy of 42.24% in the ARC-C benchmark test, and achieves a score of 26.76% in the MMLU and Heliswag tests, which is stunning. In fact, OpenELM has a wide range of application prospects, from text categorization and sentiment analysis to complex machine translation where the model may be applied. Although the smaller models beat the larger ones in terms of flexibility and speed, they do so at the expense of their own knowledge base and accuracy. As Microsoft itself said, is still fundamentally limited by its size for certain tasks. But are small models necessarily inferior to large ones? Actually, fine-tuned performance of small models may not be inferior to large models in certain usage scenarios. For example, Microsoft's Phi-3 with the smallest parameters is only 3.8B. but it is more suitable for running on laptops and even cell phones than GPT-3.5. So it is precisely for this reason that we can expect to run OpenELM locally on MacBook or iPhone. Are you looking forward to running AI on your iPhone? Leave your thoughts in the comment section. Well, that's all for today's video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time.